Work means a lot of things to a lot of people. In physics, work has a specific meaning. Work equals force times displacement. I'm using my force to move this cell phone across the table. That's work. Moving a product to market is work. Moving a rocket into space is work too. How much energy do you need to propel that rocket into space? How much gas, which possesses stored chemical energy, do you need to drive across the United States in your car? Or how much energy do you need to keep this manufacturing plant assembly line in operation? That's what the work energy theorem helps you figure out. It took about 2,000 years to figure out that forces are what make objects move and stop. When I roll this ball on the table, do you think it'll stop? Greek philosopher Aristotle did. In Aristotle's days around 320 BC, he thought objects would just naturally slow down and stop. It wasn't until Sir Isaac Newton came along almost 2,000 years later that he figured out that forces like friction that are harder to see and measure are acting on the ball and slowing it down, or other forces speeding it up. It's Newton's first law of motion. An object at rest will stay at rest, and an object in motion will stay in motion at a constant velocity unless acted upon by a net force. So without friction, this ball would just keep on rolling. Newton understood forces acting on masses, but he didn't really take into account energy's impact on how things move. That took years more to figure out. And in the world we're living in, with industry and technology, energy is critical. The key to the work energy theorem is understanding that the work you do on an object will either add energy to that object or take energy away. Remember, work equals force times displacement. So let's say I want to move this box 2 meters. If I exert 20 newtons of force on the box to move it 2 meters, then I'm doing 40 joules of work on the box. By pushing the box and increasing its velocity, the box gains 40 joules of kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is the energy of a moving object. That's the work energy theorem in a nutshell. Work is equal to the change in that object's kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 your mass times its velocity squared. The delta symbol means a change in. That means work is equal to the final kinetic energy minus the initial kinetic energy. The key is it has to be displaced. If you move it, then return it to the same spot, no work is done. Why are forces like friction important? Well, if you want to know how much friction slows down a runner sliding into base, or how big a parachute you need to slow down this shuttle, or how fast a train can safely take a curve without flying off the tracks, the work energy theorem can help you figure out these problems. And in each of those instances, friction is a key force. Friction is one of those forces that's difficult to measure. It takes away from kinetic energy. In the case of someone sliding into base, it takes kinetic energy and turns it into heat. The same way when you rub your hands together real fast, you can feel the heat. You can calculate the energy lost due to friction in problems by using physics that we've already learned. How much work does friction do if an 85-kilogram base runner travels at an initial velocity of 8 meters per second and slides into second base and then stops? So, let's write down our knowns and our unknowns. Mass is equal to 85 kilograms. Our initial velocity is 8 meters per second. Our final velocity is 0 meters per second. And we're solving for the work done by friction. And here's the equation that we need to know. Work is equal to the final kinetic energy minus the initial kinetic energy. That means that work is equal to 1/2 the mass times the final velocity squared minus 1/2 mass times the initial velocity squared. We then plug in the values we know and get work due to friction equal to 1/2 times 85 kilograms times 0 meters per second squared minus 1/2 times 85 kilograms times 8 meters per second squared. Now the first part of the equation will be equal to 0 since 0 times anything is 0, and that leaves us with 1/2 times 85 kilograms times 8 meters per second squared. When we multiply that out, we get the work done by friction to be negative 2,720 joules. So friction takes energy away from the kinetic energy of the base runner, right? Why are we getting a negative answer? Work is a scalar quantity. How can it be negative? Well, that negative sign tells us that energy was taken away from our base runner. A positive number for work would tell us that energy was added to the base runner. Does that make sense? When you think of the total work done, that is the change in energy. It's also the work to overcome forces that are hard to measure, like friction. That's what the work energy theorem allows us to solve. The work energy theorem is at the heart of understanding physics. And once you understand it, you have a much better sense of how the world works. That's it for this segment of Physics in Motion, and we'll see you next time.
For more practice problems, lab activities, and note-taking guides, check out the Physics in Motion Toolkit.